plausible. It's kind of true, but kind of wrong. So I'm going to fix in my list that I would love. Kentoo fans, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today I'm going to be doing a different video. I do ranking videos once in a while, but this time I'm doing a song ranking because I was just watching Smojo ranking the Encounter song. First of all, it's kind of true but kind of wrong, so I'm going to fix in my list that I would love the proper list if I'm being biased or anything. This is such a hard list to make, and this is my personal taste, so feel free to comment down below, share your list of the song. I'm very curious to hear why you chose them in that list. I'm very curious to hear why. Why is this song number one than the others, you know? Let me show you my reasons as I go on this video. And this can change over time as I listen to the song multiple times and I reflect on it. I'm happy that these songs are so, well, except for one, but we'll see. One particular song is so popular right now. It's not gonna be like, it's not like Let It Go level, like Frozen, but it's very popular right now. Thanks to TikTok. Thank you, TikTok. I knew this song was gonna be popular in some way. Yeah, again, most of these songs are almost no skip. Again, it depends on my mood. It depends on how I feel about slow songs, but overall, no skip. I fell in love with these songs. Learn more about these songs as you watch videos, especially on TikTok videos, of what these songs mean. Again, I have so many Encanto TikTok. Please follow my TikTok account if you want to see more Encanto content. It's in my TikTok. There's more of them. Feel free to go. Especially this meaning some behind these songs. Go for it. I almost all of them. I have a few left, but stay tuned for it. Go on my TikTok if you want. When it comes to which one is your favorite Metal Girl family? Mine right now is Dorothea. I'm so sorry if I said her name, but the she's so good. I think you know what I'm talking about. I love almost all of them, but she's the one that stood out to me. So for now, let's just get right into it. So there are 8 songs from this soundtrack. So I'm going to start with number 8, All of You. Again, I wasn't really into this song until they do the Lin-Manuel Miranda thingy. That's when I'm like, okay, we're in for this song. Especially when they talk about Bruno, of course. It's a great song. It's a great song to end the story of the Metal Girl family. And the song is about self-empowerment, loving yourself, forgiving your family, you know what I mean? I think this song is below because, like, I haven't listened to it a lot of times, to be honest with you. It's a cute song, it's a great farewell, like, analysis. I'm not really, you know, it's kind of weird when they play the song and then the next one comes around, you know? I'll get into that song later on. Again, I love all of these songs. Again, the only thing I love in the song is when they add the Lin-Manuel Miranda to us with the piano. Again, it's about, like, self-love. It kind of brings closure to directors, like, problems throughout the entire film, so I'll give them that. Family. So number 7, this pains me to put this at second last because again, I don't know, for their songs. This is Metal Girl Family. Again, when I first heard this song, it's a great opening song. It's a great song to introduce who the Metal Girl families are. And Maribel. I feel like you love this. I love Maribel. Maribel is such an adorable, nerdy Disney character I wish I grew up having. Like, I'm so happy that little children can look up to her. She's like a stereotype sidekick, but she's actually a main character. So like, she's such a great role model. And I feel like this song, again, it feels, when I first heard this song, watching it in theater, I'm like, oh, I love it. Again, it's so cute. It's kind of like a guilty pleasure type of song. You know what I mean? The Metal Girl family. I knew it. It's like, they found the same formula from Belle from Beauty and the Beast. I think Belle is a better opening song, this one, to be honest with you. But then, like, kind of reminds me of, like, a Dora song. Like, Dora. Just imagine Dora the Explorer singing this song, introducing, like, her family. Kind of reminds me of that. I mean, it's pretty cool. It really showcased Maribel's personality. It's a great opening song. It makes my heart, again, it's kind of like that guilty pleasure song. That's why I'm putting it at number 7. So, number 6. This pains me to put this at number. It's the, I can't pronounce it in Spanish, but Dos Ortigueta. It's for English, it's called Two Caterpillars. Again, I wasn't really into this song until, again, I didn't listen to these songs when I first saw the movie. It's like, I watch it in open-minded, so, which is a great idea. I feel like we should all do it for all musicals, so anyway. It's a very slow song, and I really love how they sing it in Spanish, which is amazing. I feel like I love this song a lot more if I know the meaning behind it. Because I was thinking, why did I cry a lot? I forgot why, the reason why I cried for this song. I'm like, that's the song why I cried so much, is the story behind the Abibella, her story with this song. And the message is, it's just very sad. Again, as my friend says, is they're trying to do like a Remember Me, Coco? I feel like Remember Me does it better than this song. But again, it's so sad. I feel, yeah, it's a, that's why it's already down the list. It's just like, I have no intention to like listen to it again, but then like, and again, it depends on my mood. There's times where I might want to listen to this song again. Also reminds me a bit of like Under the Sea, because I know Lynn loves Little Mermaid. I see some influence with that Little Mermaid with the song, especially like with the melody, the sounding, especially in the way this singer sang the song, reminds me of like Little Mermaid, like Under the Sea. So there's that, and it's a very sad song. I feel like I need to see the visual aid to listen to the song. That's the reason why I cry. Okay, so number 5, it's another Spanish-English type of song. It's Colombia, Mi Encanto. Lots of people put this at the bottom. I don't think it's not that bad. Every time I listen to the song, it makes me want to dance. It's like a celebration of your culture. I love that this song really it makes me love Colombia. It's like a great dance song. They use this song for like the teaser. It's an okay song. I don't know. I just wish that this was the perfect song to end the music. I mean, to end the movie. Because it started with like not beats on it. It ends with all of it. It's kind of like a slow ballad. Meet Colombia. This song was a great way to. I wish that Magophone would sing the song, honestly. Then, and it's not Lynn, it's another Colombia singer that sang the song, but yeah, I don't know, it just wasn't really, I mean, it is for me, I love this song, so I put it in number 5, but I just love, it just makes me want to dance, it makes me feel happy, you know, we love happy songs, so that's what the soundtrack did serve, sadness and happiness. So yeah, it's a cute song, that's why I put it in number 5. Okay, so number 4, this song, this would have been bottom until I read the lyrics, see if you understand, if you analyze the character, what she's feeling in this moment. It's Waiting for a Miracle. When I first heard this song, this would have been bottom instantly. But then I fell in love with it. I fell in love with the character Maribel because I really, really relate to what she's feeling, like feeling left out from a group. Can be not just your family, can be like a friend, anything. Like just being isolated from your group, you really want to be part of this group. So Waiting for a Miracle, she really, again, it's Stephanie, like their voice. It's not like a Disney princess type of voice, but then like if you read the lyrics and watch your facial expression singing the song, it makes me cry. Again, you have to be in the perfect mood to listen to the song. That's why I put it in number 4 because I just fell in love with the song so much. And it's one of the saddest I want Disney songs, to be honest with you. It's very relatable, of course, and I can see Lynn mentions about like how he has Precious and Rennie, like the iconic I Want Disney song. It might take you a while to fall in love with this song, but I would skip it. It's like a great I Want song for Mira. I fell in love with it, of course, as time went on. That's why it's number 4 on my list. It could possibly change. Speak of another song that I kind of fell in love as time goes on, is Surface Pressure. It's Luciana, Maribel's older sister, and as an older sibling myself, I can really relate to what she's experiencing with everything. I think all older siblings can relate to this, like feeling the pressure and everything. And again, when I first heard the song, I just wasn't really like a fan of it. I'm like, huh? Because I was watching Grace Randolph, like she said she likes this song. I'm like, okay. I love how when she sings this song, you can really feel the anxiety of the song, which is, it's not like a perfect Disney princess, you know, like song. It's like you can really, the voice actress did such an amazing job really showcasing what the anxiety feels like and how there's a bridge towards the song where she talks about. Also, the visual is amazing too. All the songs are amazing. It's one of the beautiful visual songs, and I'm so happy it's one of the most popular songs as it deserves. And I think I really hope that it shows children, older siblings in general, you don't have to take all the pressures from your family all the time. It's okay to relax. You need to relax as a human being, because relaxing, I like how she desires for relaxation because she's always like on the go all the time, like the pressure of on the go all the time. So it's very nice to have a song for people like us that's anxiety. It's also pretty cool. I love the beat too, and it makes Encanto like different, unique Disney musical, if you know what I mean. Speaking of musical, I love this song so much. It would have been number 1, but another song is better than number 1, of course. I love Else Can I, that's why it's number 2. I love this song so much. This is one of the songs that stood out to me after I watched my first movie in Cali. Like, I love this movie. That's why I even said on my Twitter, like, it's like top tier Disney movie, honestly. What Else Can I Do? It's such an amazing sister song. It's like a Disney princess type of song, basically, because Isabella is like a Disney princess. Even Maribel calls her a princess, because like she's always perfect all the time. It really showcased Diana Gormani, who voiced, I love her so much too. It really showcased how talented she is. I don't know why she didn't think of her. She should be a Disney princess. She is a Disney princess, even though she's not, but like, really showcased how beautiful her voice is. And I love the dynamic between the siblings. They're trying to forgive themselves. I don't know. It kind of reminds me of like, I wish Elsa and Anna have this type of song together. It's kind of like Anna's, Elsa's, it's kind of like the first movie where like Elsa is like, forgive me. And Elsa's like, no, like, I'm too focused on exploring my power. I don't know. It's such a fun song. It's a great uplifting song. Also, the message behind it's like, you need to be imperfect to find out who you are. Being imperfect really showcases who you are as a person. It's beautiful. Being imperfect can be beautiful. That's what the song really showcases as Isabella discovers her unique power she didn't know she had. That's why the song is number two. It's a really special message. I feel like kids need to hear it nowadays, even us two adults too. So yeah, number two. I love What Else Can I Do. I always look forward to that number, and maybe I want to rewatch and catch it over and over again. It's such a number, and I love the poppiness. I think poppy makes you want to listen to it again. It's such an amazing song. If you don't like it, probably don't love pop music, or like, you still really get Isabella's like message, but it's my list, so yeah. The number one song we will all forgive, we'll all love, is We Don't Talk About Blue Now. When I first watched it, I was like, everybody's talking about this song. Like, even Lynn was hyping this song. Like, okay, what is so special about this song? I gotta see it myself. And I'm like, okay, here it is. It's such a bop. It's so different from Let It Go. I'm so happy it's popular as it deserves. I think, especially when you hear, like, what I love about musicals, hearing, like, different, like, vocal arrangements with the characters. I love it so much. That's what makes me love musicals all over again. It just brings me back to my old roots. This could be known as a Disney typical villain, so it's not really. It's kind of like, this song really does a great job as to showcase how dangerous Bruno is, and he really showcased the insecures of like the Marigold family that are singing this song. It's so popular. I even love Brenda's like line in it. It's so popular right now, as it deserves. Like, this song deserves to be in the popularity. I think it's better than Let It Go. And it's a fun song. It showcased different genres of music all in one song. The pacing of it's very different, and I'm happy everybody loves the song as it deserves. That's why it's number one in all of our lists. So these are my top 8 list for Encanto songs. Let me know, console, which one is your favorite list? Agree or disagree? Feel free to before Christmas mine. I want to hear yours as to what is your number one and why is it? Why is it listed that way? Because I already showed you mine. So yeah, this can change over time as time goes on. But as of right now, this is my number one list. So if you like more Disney content on my channel, please just make sure you subscribe and like, and so you don't miss any videos like this. And I'll see you all next time on next Disney video. Okay, happy New Year once again. Okay. See y'all soon. Okay, bye. Boop. Again, she doesn't look like a teenager. She looks like a child. She looks like she's 10 or 12 year old.
Oh, wait, that's it? Okay.